Hello everyone. As all of us love pampering our skin, what else could be better if we could go all natural with it? So we are here with 5 amazing natural DIY masks for all of you. So without blabbering much, let's dive into the video. Hi. With summers bracing our lives, all of us are bound to have skin issues. And being a person having an oily skin myself, we have to bear the wrath left, right and center. But what do we do? Do we sit and crib about it? Not at all. We have come up with 5 effective DIYs with ingredients that you will find around your house, in your kitchen, very easily. And yes, they are effective, so just try them out and let us know. So starting off with our first DIY for acne prone skin, we have Multani Mitti out here, sandalwood powder, aloe vera gel and rose water. We'll mix it up in this bowl and apply it all over your face. As you guys can see, I've applied the mask evenly on my entire face and now I'll wait for about 15 to 20 minutes for it to dry off and I'll wash it off and come back again. So I washed my face and my skin feels completely free from oil and refreshed to another level. So what are you waiting for? Go and try this out for yourself.
Hi guys, I'm here with mask number 2. No matter how much sunscreen we apply, we know that summer is here and we are going to get tanned. So I'm coming up with a mask which is going to help you detan. See you on the other side. Here I have taken 2 tablespoons of Bengal gram flour, which is basil, few drops of lemon juice, half a teaspoon of honey, half a tablespoon of fresh cream, which is malai, and a pinch of turmeric. I'm going to mix all these up and apply it to my face now. This is how the paste came out when I mixed all the ingredients. My cream was a little thick, so I used rose water instead of using normal water. You can even use normal water if you don't have it around your house. Hi, so I have applied it now evenly on my face. I'm going to give it a good 15 minutes and then I'm going to just lightly scrub it with water and then take it off. Be careful, go light, don't be harsh on your face. And I'm done. My skin is feeling so nice and fresh. One thing I forgot to mention, do not forget to apply the mask on your neck as well. Otherwise, you will have 2 different skin tones and you don't want that. Please try this out and let us know in the comments if you've liked this mask. See ya. Hello, I'm back with mask number 3. This mask is made of rice flour. This is going to help you in pigmentation. It'll help to dull dark spots and it also helps your skin's texture. So let's begin. And these are the ingredients. They are 100% from home. Rice flour, which I have made from rice in my dry grinder. Cucumber juice, which I have grated fresh. And some aloe vera from my garden. You can even use the store-bought one. All set. I'm going to wait for about 20 minutes and then I'm going to gently scrub it off. Make sure that you apply it on the neck as well. This mask may look a little grainy to you because I made the flour at home. The store-bought one may be slightly smoother. Skin feels super soft. It has also brightened up my skin a little. So try it out and let me know how you like this mask.
Yes, you've guessed it right. I'm a night owl. How did you guess it? Obviously, I look like an owl because of my dark circles. I seriously want to get rid of them. How do I do that? Well, I have an amazing DIY homemade mask for you. For making this homemade mask, we would need 1 tablespoon of coffee and 1 tablespoon of honey, and then we have to mix it well. As you can see, I've applied the mixture and I'll be waiting for 15 minutes so that this is completely dry. So I washed off the pack and now I can see a visible difference. I mean, I look less of an owl now and more of a human.
Hi guys, I'm here to show you the 5th DIY mask. Now this is great for people with acne prone skin. It's the Fuller's Earth and Green Tea mask. I'm going to quickly show you the ingredients that you'll need to make this one.
So here are the ingredients that you'll need for the mask. You'll need about 2 tablespoons of Multani Mitti or Fuller's Earth, 1 tablespoon of green tea, and some aloe vera gel. I'll mix it up and show you how it looks. So I've mixed all the ingredients and this is how it looks. I've added sufficient amount of aloe vera gel
to form a medium to sort of a thick consistency.
As you can see, I have applied the mask evenly all over my face. And since my skin is oily, I have used aloe vera gel for the mix. In case your skin is dry, we would recommend that you use honey. And I'm going to leave this on for 15 minutes until it dries out. And then I'll just wash it off with lukewarm water. As you can see, I have washed off the mask with lukewarm water and my skin feels so refreshed and nice. How this mask works is basically green tea has antioxidants which help fight bacteria on your skin, whereas Multani Mitti or Fuller's Earth helps control the sebum on your skin, thereby, you know, calming down your breakouts and helping reduce your acne. And you all might know that aloe vera gel is super soothing on the skin. It feels nice and cool. And in case you use the honey version of the mask, you realize that, you know, your skin feels nice and firm and tight. So do try out this mask and let us know how it worked out for you. Until then, see you.
Hey, you guys. So these were the 5 amazing DIYs. Do try them out and let us know in the comment section below how did you like it. Also, you know the drill, right? Do like, share and subscribe to the channel. And don't forget to follow us on our social medias to get the insights. Till then, just stay home and stay safe. We'll see you next time.